Welcome back again today, friends. I have, it's nothing new, we do this. But wait, Jay Morell, you just had a big grocery haul come out. I know, I spent a lot of food. Here's the receipt. Yep, the cashier was scared and I said, honey, this ain't nothing. This is two carts, this is nothing, nothing. So what in the world am I doing? Okay, quick little story time with Jay Morell. You've probably heard me mention this if you've watched my recent vlogs. I have one of my very best friends does mission work in Haiti. She has gone before and worked in the orphanages with one of her daughters, and they visit many different orphanages. They do pretty much like a VBS program, and they've been planning for a year now to go back this summer. Now, my first noted information is that they are fundraising now, because now summer, it's like car wash time, bake sale time. We're getting ready to do all this meal prep and bulk cooking for 40 other families for an upcoming fundraiser. That info's coming up. Just gotta give you this little bit of backstory. They're heavily fundraising now, and all the money is going through their church. The church is holding it for them. Just wanna say this disclaimer, that even though they are pushing, and she's been watching the Haiti travel regulations, everything in everyone's life is super complicated now. Mm-hmm. If there's any way that they can still go in August for 10 days, how they have been planning and fundraising for, they are going. But their backup plan is, if for some reason, and she was explaining the different travel regulations to me, there's like, if one more thing is lifted, they can buy their tickets and most likely be able to go. But if this one thing that I'm gonna speak ignorantly about, and I can't even say ignorantly, if this one thing isn't lifted, then they're doing all this fundraising now and they will be going to Haiti as soon as possible. She's thinking if they can't go in August, it's gonna circle back around and be this fall, maybe not even until November. So we are doing it, but she's been pushing for months. Girlfriend, she signed up to do chicken butchering and poultry butchering at a local pasture-raised farm to raise money for her trip. Hey kid, what else has she done? They've done a lot of car washes. They've done a lot of bake sales. Well, and we're getting ready to do these 40 meals. Then that gets me back to a recent discussion. She was sharing with me how a good friend of hers has done lots of fundraising for her various adoptions, has done these like casserole dinner type fundraisers where her friend has made a 9x13 meal and then maybe had some rolls and a little something else with it. And she made those for her fundraiser to help fund her various expenses. So my friend asked me, do you think you can like, do you have some recipes? Do you have, I mean, she knows I spend a lot of food and I only know Mega and Lots. So I'm the friend to have if you wanna make a whole lot of meals for a huge fundraiser, yay. And I was like, oh, girlfriend, I can, let's do this. You need 40, 30, 40 or 50 9x13 meals? Gotcha, got you covered. But I did some shortcuts that are like absolutely ridiculous. Even the cashier at Walmart told me, she's like, it's ridiculous that you're doing it this way. So just know there's some ridiculousness coming up. So I'm gonna show you this haul and then I'll explain to you what every family is getting. Okay, so let's just, here's the table. Here's all the stuff. I'll tell you the total and the breakdown on what it's costing us per meal. As of right now, we're doing this for 40 families, but I've left enough wiggle room. I, you know, of course, bought a little extra here and there to make sure we can take care of any straggling orders that come in. Order cutoff was yesterday, and she shared with her church and Facebook, and we've shared locally. Anyway, but let's just stop off on, okay, so if Jay Morell is one of your best friends, and if I am helping you make a bunch of meals for 40 families, there does come to be a reality checkpoint, okay? Yes, I bought pre-made rolls, and I bought pre-made cookies, because I'm that kind of lazy person. Really, I am a full-time working mama, and there's, you know, it's gotta be give and take. This is how my whole life is. So there's lots of things I will make, and then some things I just buy, and that's the best that I can do. Now, I had recipes ready. We were gonna do a bunch of homemade rolls, and we were gonna do a bunch of cookies. We were gonna spend, we thought half, but I was thinking it's probably realistically like all day tomorrow. We're doing two meal prep days. Sorry, no painted fingernails in this haul, but Talking Hand is still moving forward. And then just when I looked at the magnitude of what we were trying to pull off in 2 days, and I thought, huh, I think I want to work in my garden a little bit instead. Girlfriend, I'm buying rolls and I'm buying cookies. So my part in all of this is our family has bought the supplies. I was explaining to the kids, some people are called to go and serve. Some people are called to send, and this is our little part in helping send our good friend and her team. She's taking two other young adults with her, and they're gonna work at 5 orphanages for 10 days and do a lot of things. So I can't go to Haiti right now, but I could help someone else go. Back to Mama bought rolls, Mama bought cookies. Yeah, I bought all 4 of these. Is this 4? No, this is 5. I'll tell you my math breakdown on how many rolls we needed. You are gonna have to just stick with me for this grocery haul. Okay, so we needed at least 240 rolls. We were thinking 6 rolls per family. I bought 264. We needed 8 cookies per family, 320. I bought 372. And so the menu of what each family is getting is they're getting a 9x13 casserole of their choice. They had the choices between our millionaire spaghetti casserole. Then I have an amazing chicken teriyaki casserole that has not been out on YouTube yet, but look for our upcoming Super Mega Lots all day meal prep cooking videos. You'll see that recipe in action. And then my tater tot casserole made with beef. Pretty sure I've shared my tater tot casserole made with chicken, but I've got a ground beef variation that I'm cooking up too. So the families who are participating in the fundraiser had 3 casserole choices, then they're getting rolls and cookies and fruit salad. Now, all of a sudden, last night I was like, oh man, where do we get the big bulk cans of fruit salad? Because it's one of those items. At first we were gonna do fresh salad, and then we were worried about lettuce and, you know, all the things that could go wrong with salad. So my friend thought ahead and she was able to get her hands on, I think it's the 120 ounce big cans of the fruit salad. And she had containers that were donated for those. And she had 39 of the 9x13 pans donated. And you'll see I got a few extra. So then that's where the cashier was like, oh my goodness, lady, what are you doing? I mean, she obviously doesn't know me. And I said, when I was saying, oh, sweetie, this is nothing. But I did mention to her, I was helping a friend do a fundraiser. And then she said, it would have been so much cheaper for you to make your rolls and your cookies. And I said, yes, but my sanity and my time are worth something, and this is the best I can do. There you go. Okay, so 10 things of cottage cheese, you know it. 12 case of pineapple chunks. Now, for the chicken teriyakis, I think we have 16 orders for those, and we needed 9 of the cans. So I just bought a little extra for all of them. With the spaghetti, we needed 15 cans, and I just did not want to send Zion to go back and get 3 cans. I had him go down the aisle for these. I thought, that's okay. I will get 3 of my cans of spaghetti sauce for that one, but I didn't do that for everything. Chicken broth. I'm pretty sure we needed 6 of those, so that's just 2 extra. Got 5 things of spaghetti, because for our orders for the millionaire spaghetti, we need 15 pounds of spaghetti cooked. Cream cheese, we need that. I needed a total of 360 ounces of mixed vegetables for the chicken teriyaki. And then I needed about 8 more cups for the ground beef casserole. And so for these 5 80 ounce bags, we have 400 ounces total. And that's as far down the rabbit trail as I can go. It's more than enough. My math brain is done. And then we need onions, whole lot of onions. I got 2 packs. Now, spice wise, for the chicken teriyaki casserole, we just sprinkle some sesame seeds on the top when we're done, and then we'll also be sending some green onions as a garnish. Got some more sesame seeds. Now, this ground mustard has nothing to do with any of these recipes. Only the last 2 recipes I did for my special large family table community membership needed ground mustard, and I've been out. So I'm making these recipes like you put in ground mustard, even though I don't have any, ha ha. So I was like, I'm getting 2 of those jokers today. Whole lot of cheese, 20 pounds of shredded cheese total. Hope it's enough. Again, I went as far down the rabbit trail with the math as I could. Then I needed 27 cups of uncooked rice. So I got a 20 pound bag. I think we're good. All the tater tots. I got, let's see, 6 bags of tater tots. That's for the ground beef casserole. Picked up some more plastic wrap and foil. You know I ran out of my Costco stuff and I'm still sad about that. Got some smaller quart bags. I thought maybe cookies would go in here and we could put the rolls in the freezer bags. Also, they had 10 of these 9x13x9 or 9x13 cans, and I always need those in hand for different meals. Freezer paper has nothing to do with this. I think these were about $6.74 or so each. I've never used a lot of freezer paper, but I saw it has directions on here for wrapping meat. And you know the other part of my life, I'm raising meat and processing it, and I'm going to at least freeze what I can. And I want to can a lot of it, but I'm not necessarily gonna be able to flip around and get it canned quickly. I mean, it might have to be frozen for 2 months before I can slowly work through it all. Just doing the best I can. But I got some freezer paper because it's another option, right? And then here it also has the recommended list of keeping various things in the freezer. Yes, something new in my life. And there were no product or meat limitations in the store. I don't think my local Walmart minded my business today, and there was plenty of meat left, so don't think I'm a mean cow. I needed a total of 35 pounds of meat, so I bought 6 of the 5-pound rolls. We'll have a few extra pounds. Again, even though we're planning for 40 orders, I'm just prepping a little bit ahead if we do have a few more stragglers. The cutoff was yesterday, but you know, if she gets 2 or 3 more, I know she won't turn them down, which is fine. So then chicken thighs. I don't buy a lot of chicken thighs, but Walmart actually had a lot of them marked down today. This is one of the few that were not marked down. So this pack, let's see, I needed a total of 45 pounds of chicken thighs. And I thought, oh, Walmart. Now my closest Walmart has been doing well with meat, but I just going in, I thought, okay, Lord, let there be chicken thighs. And there were chicken thighs. So these were $2.32 a pound, 3.84 pounds. All the packs are similar except, yes, then I started, I probably got, let me do my math, 2, 4, 6, 8. So at least 6 of these are marked down with the sticker, bringing them down to $1.74 a pound. I got about 40 pounds that way. And so I had to fill in with these smaller packs of thighs that were more expensive per pound. It ended up being like the last 5 pounds. So that is okay. And so the ground beef is for the beef tater tot casserole and the millionaire spaghetti. And then all the chicken thighs are for the super amazing, coming at you real soon in the next video, chicken teriyaki casserole. And then with the cookies, we were planning to do all of them with chocolate chip. And I bought them out of the chocolate chip. So I filled in the rest of the way with the M&M. And also we took some special requests as far as dairy-free meals. My particular good friend I'm doing all this cooking with, she's been dairy-free for a long time. So she said for the folks who needed dairy-free, we're doing a dairy-free dessert. It's going to be dairy-free Rice Krispie treats. So she knows the switching out and the adaptations for that. So we'll be sharing that in all our cooking day videos. So here you go. All of it. Okay, so let me tell you my total. The total on my receipt, including tax. Tax was $17. What are these jokers in Virginia doing, I tell you? Okay, so subtotal was $369.50. Total with tax was $357.48. Check the receipt, and there was $45.92. My freezer paper that I didn't even need to show you, but there you go, now you saw it. And then a few other things I had picked up for my family came to $45.92. Okay, so total $611.56 for all the supplies to do the meals. And she already has 40 orders. That makes the cost that we have spent per family that we're serving $15.28. And for the fundraiser, the meals are donation only. Every family's getting a 9x13 meal. They're getting 6 cookies, 8 rolls, and fruit salad, and it's gonna be delivered to their house. We have 2 teams for our 2 local counties, 4 young adults total, a whole lot of coolers, and these young adults are going to deliver the meals to all these families who've ordered. I feel like that's a really great value. Now I'm gonna sit here for a minute. I'm gonna add up how much all my silly cookies cost and how much all my already made rolls cost. Because if you're doing something similar to this, obviously add in a third day. If we had 3 days to do this, we could take the first day to make the rolls and all the cookies. And yes, now that I'm thinking about it, that's a pretty good all day truck to do several hundred of each. Then the next day, what we're doing is mega meal prep. We're cooking up everything we can possibly cook up. The rice, the noodles, the ground beef, chopping, dicing, getting it all ready. And then on the next day, when our young adults are gonna run these meals around to all these families and deliver them, we're assembling them, getting them all together, getting them packaged, getting them out the door. So it is a big undertaking. We're gonna have so much fun doing it though. Our families always have fun working together. If both of us with our schedules could have added in another day, we could have doctored it up even more, but I'm real excited about what we have done. Okay, so telling all my sins, it was $55.43 for all the pre-made rolls. And you know you could have made all those rolls for $10 or less, but that's okay. Like I said, this is my little bit of mama's sanity, and with my time of not having to make rolls and cookies all day tomorrow, we can get all this meal prep done. And somewhere in all that, I'm gonna get you all a new garden tour video filmed and out, so you're welcome. $59.40 in pre-made cookies. So total, $114 between these cookies and these rolls that I'm probably making way too big of a deal out of. But I'd just like y'all to know, you know, folks say, Jamrell, how do you do all this stuff? How do you get this stuff done? Or Jamrell, you're a sloppy mess. I can't believe you're doing anything. And so the in-between is, there's a lot of things we can get done, like we're gonna make all these dinners and do all this prep work and pull it all together and repackage it. And then some things, I take the easy route, just like at homeschool group, if we need to, I don't know, bring cookies for a party, I will buy the tray of cookies at Costco, okay? And I did not go to Costco because it's too far right now. 3 minutes down the road is it for me. So it was $114 I spent to buy pre-made rolls and pre-made cookies. Total, $20, probably could have made all of these homemade from scratch, but again, the trade-off is the time. So it could have been around $500 for doing all the meals if the rolls and cookies would have been made, and then if I divide that down, and that would have made it $12.52 per meal per family for this fundraiser that we're doing. So now you got the little cost benefit analysis going on of the breakdown of what it's costing us to do it. And then the hope is that families will end up donating more than what it cost us to do each meal, so that at the end of the day, it helps with their Haiti mission trip. So anyway, friends, thank you for watching this large family grocery haul for 40 families, maybe a little more. All the videos coming up of us doing big batch cooking, bulk cooking, mega meal planning. I had to majorly multiply a lot of my big recipes to do all of this for this fundraiser, but all those meals will be coming out. Now this will be helpful. I talked to a lady today. She makes a lot of meals for the homeless and she was looking for more recipes. Well, what we're gonna cook up, we're doing at least, I think, 16 pans of the chicken teriyaki. We're doing 15 pans of the millionaire spaghetti. We're doing, I think, 20 pans of the chicken teriyaki casserole. A lot of the ground beef casserole, I think 15 pans of the millionaire spaghetti casserole. So a lot of these recipes and big bulk cooking, if you're doing ministry meals, if you're doing fundraising meals, I know I talked to another viewer I've heard from before. She told me she loves to cook up all my bulk recipes, and she's a military mama, and those service men and women love to have home-cooked meals, and so when she's able, she does a bunch of bulk cooking and makes casseroles and dinner dishes for them. So look for our meal prep videos and all our mega cooking videos. I'm even gonna show you where we repackage it, how we send it off for delivery, and just all the fun that's coming up in the next few days. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you real soon with another brand new video. Bye-bye. A little bonus footage, this is how we're setting it up now. Friday, we have our on-sale couch being delivered for here, and books that need to go on bookshelves I got for there, okay. Anyway, so we put up this camping table, as I call it. We're gonna set all the non-perishable items for the fundraiser here, and then we'll be doing a lot of the bulk meal prep here. Okay, finally, over and out. Talk to you soon, bye-bye.